Hello and welcome to this addendum of the patterns tutorial that I was doing. Somebody asked, and then erased the comment later, how to save patterns. Now, it seems they got their answer, but I want other people to have their own answer for this. The big thing about patterns are bitmap images. That's all they are. How they're designed determines how well they tile. Now, you can use any type of bitmap image. You can use a BMP, you can use a JPEG, you can use a GIF, you can use a PNG. You know, you can even use a PaintShop Pro image. It will allow you to do that. The whole big thing with patterns is learning where to save the pattern. Now, to do that, I want to show you this really quick. You go to File, Preferences, and file locations. Click on that. Under the file types dialog box, we select patterns. This will bring up all the information on how patterns are saved and, or not how they're saved, but where they're saved and how to look up that information. For example, if we have patterns in subfolders to our actual pattern folder, we would want to have this selected. That way it will look in all the subfolders for extra patterns. Now, patterns that we create should be saved in the MyPSP files under the Patterns folder. This is usually found in the documents, in your documents. So, you can look there. Corel's default ones are saved under Corel 08 folder inside the Corel PaintShop Pro program folder. We won't be dealing with these ones. We'll just be saving everything to here. Okay, so you can go ahead and hit cancel since we haven't changed anything. Now here's one pattern that I made. I called it Levi Circles. It's not fancy by any stretch of the imagination, obviously, but what we're going to do is we're going to go File, Save As, and you'll notice I've already got everything set up. You got my documents, PSP files, patterns, and it's now Levi Circles is already saved here, but if we just go ahead and hit save anyway, yes, replace, then we close out. We can now use that as our pattern. There it is. Oop, stop that. Okay. Hit OK, grab our fill tool, and click. We have a pattern of circles. Now that was a 100 by 100 pixel image, so there's not a whole lot of detail. But you can get a lot of interesting effects by doing similar things. I go, it fits all the exact same requirements as before. Scale, rotation, angle. Everything, it's just a simple bitmap image saved to the proper folder. And that's how you make your own patterns.